Shri Kiranji, the president of the Youth for Seva, the man behind the national network of the Youth for Seva, Venkatesh Murthy ji, the corporate vice president of Infosys, Shri Kant Murthy ji, Santosh ji, Madan Patki ji, Dharmesh ji, other dignitaries sitting in the auditorium, and young ladies and gentlemen. Let me start with a disclaimer. I am certainly not a boss, and therefore don't remain under the impression that somebody, because I mean boss and the hierarchical connotations or terminologies are basically in the corporate sector, and I had a very brief brush with the corporate sector. I was never in the corporate sector. I can claim that I was more in the voluntary sector, and let me tell you, the politics is also a voluntary sector. But first of all, let me thank the organizers for having invited me to share my thoughts with you. It's really a very enriching experience to be seeing all young minds bubbling with enthusiasm and who have worked and who have committed to work in the future for the society, for the country, which is so very encouraging. And especially when you travel from the Bangalore airport to this place, spending more than 2.5 hours, and then when you are greeted with a lush green campus of the Infosys, it's really a great joy. And therefore, I'm really happy to be amongst all of you here on this bright morning. Friends, corporate social responsibility is something which we have been hearing about a little before the Act came into force, and thereafter during the last 5-6 years or so. But I believe the tradition in our society, in our country, of social responsibility, it certainly may be millennia old. Because in our country, the kind of idea of autonomous society that the philosophical, doctrinal foundations of our country, the idea of India, if I may say so, it goes much beyond in the past, and we have always seen various institutions in our society who were contributing their bit. Of course, at that point of time, it was not called as corporate social responsibility or even social responsibility for that matter. Take the examples of temples in our country, especially in South. There are many temples who have been engaging in distributing food to the hungry for, I don't know, centuries together. They never said it that it is the Devasthana's social responsibility, but they were doing it silently, quietly. And therefore, this has been a part of our ethos, collective social ethos. Even today, for example, in several villages, there are practices in certain families, definitely, and in most families, if I may say so, that the head of the family, before he takes his afternoon food, would move around the house, would inquire if there is anybody hungry. Had everybody taken food? And would also keep a portion of his food right at the doorstep for the birds and animals and whosoever, even insects for that matter, and then would consume the food. So to think about the other has been a part of the culture of this country. It has been a quintessential aspect of our ethos, beyond doubt. But when there are legislations, and in view of the legislations, people try to adopt some practices, nothing wrong about it. but need not be confined to that only. And if I take a look at how things have evolved after the Corporate Social Responsibility Act came into existence, unfortunately, the things are not very encouraging. I am not here to blame any particular section of the society. And whatever the corporates are doing, I am sure it must be serving some cause, achieving some objective. But there are other things also which we cannot overlook. For example, unfortunately, after the CSR came into existence, not so many well-researched studies are around about the impact of CSR, unfortunately, and from the socialistic developmental point of view. But whatever knowledge, body of knowledge that is available today, I can reasonably say that after the Act came into existence, unfortunately, we see some kind of a divide in the society. There are people who write checks and there are people who get checks. When we say CSR, when we say corporate social responsibility, the idea is certainly not only about a financial assistance, help, grant, or whatever you call it. It is much more beyond that. And therefore, if CSR is going to create an impression that there are people who are earning handsomely, there are corporate houses who are doing a brisk business, and since the business they are getting is from the very society in which they operate, they need to be socially responsible. And as a mark of their social responsibility, they need to be sharing a particular part of their profit for the cause of the society. That is welcome, but not enough. Because otherwise, as I said, it is likely to, and it has already created this kind of a divide, that we are the corporates, we will write checks to your trust organizations. And you know, when there are acts and legislations, there is always a possibility which is inherent to the framework of the Act that people try to find some scapegoat source. And there are houses, corporate houses, who have created their own foundations, they write check to their own foundations themselves. So the money keeps on rolling within their near ones and dear ones only, doesn't reach, frankly speaking, to the society, to those who deserve it. Of course, there are good examples also. There are several other corporate organizations who have resolutely engaged themselves in a more effective and a more transformative CSR as well. And certainly their efforts are very commendable. But the idea behind corporate volunteering, I believe, goes much beyond that. Because when you divide, when you have that kind of a division in your mind that we are the corporates, and when we say we are the corporates, there are the company directors, owners, and the employees also. So we are the corporates, we are earning profits, and as per the law mandates, we are sharing the part of the profit with the society, and therein is our corporate responsibility, social responsibility. I think with this corporate volunteering, the discourse about CSR has gone much, much beyond that, and for this the credit has to go to the youth for Seva. Because this volunteering, this idea of volunteering is a very powerful idea. It has several dimensions in it. Of course, corporate houses need to be and should be and are giving funds. They need to do that. But the employees in corporate houses also need to take out some time of their very hectic schedule, I understand, for the cause of the society. Because that is going to bridge the gap. That is going to take those who are in a comparatively comfortable situation to those who are leading a life of misery and deprivation. Otherwise, unfortunately, these gaps in the society are enlarging with every passing day, and due to these gaps, again, they have multiple dimensions. These are psychological gaps, there are geographical gaps, there are language gaps. The society is getting fragmented. A segment of the society is oblivious of the other segment of the society. People very easily shrug their shoulders and say, oh, I don't know. Because they really don't know, and they don't feel that they need to know what all is happening around in the society, in our country, all over the world for that matter. And therefore, volunteering opens up those opportunities of, first of all, understanding the society in which we live. What kind of society it is? In fact, let me tell you that the very idea of non-government organizations, voluntary organizations, which in this particular terminology was identified sometime in the mid-70s, if I may say it or analyze it that way. And suddenly the entire world saw a boom of NGOs. And then we had all these terminologies coming, NGO culture, NGOism, everything. And the very idea of NGO, in fact, I don't like the term, because the reference point in the term NGO is the government, and which is not acceptable in the idea of autonomous society. Government has its role, but everything that is beyond government, which is non-government, kills the idea of voluntarism. Voluntarism is a more powerful idea. Voluntarism had something to do with your own inspiration, with your self-motivation. NGO doesn't say that. And eventually it so happened that NGOs, I mean government organizations and their failure, it became very clear sometime in 60s, 70s, after the third wave of democracy, which the world saw in mid-40s, when, for example, India attained its independence and several other colonial countries. And the idea was that when democracy is there, naturally, welfare of the people will automatically happen, because people themselves are going to elect their representatives, and their representatives will take care of the welfare of the people. But it didn't happen that way. Because those who got elected became a part of the system, which is government. And therefore, the gulf between people and the government continued, even with a democratic setup. That is, in fact, a very telling comment upon the success or the failure of democracy. But that's a different story. So, with the realization that even in a democratic setup, governments are not going to be successfully reaching out to the society, especially the marginal, the peripheral sections, the deprived sections, NGOs came into the picture. And they said, and of course, bodies like United Nations and all global bodies also clamored for NGOs, NGOs. And then suddenly we saw a boom of NGOism. And for every other cause, there was maybe hundreds and thousands of NGOs. Non-government, because government cannot do it, non-government can do it. That was the idea behind. Unfortunately, during the last more than 50 years or so, or 40 years, NGOism also has shown that it has its own limitations. Because NGOs themselves became a part of the government in a way. And we see it how NGOs in a way partner with the government and then behave like the government only. They have their own bureaucracy also. So the very idea of inspirated, self-motivated class of people serving the cause of the society, going extra mile, in a way, met its burial with this boom of NGOism. And therefore, again, we were back to square one. Maybe, I don't know what exactly, but somewhere around the discourse went to a particular stage where the idea of CSR came up, and now we have this CSR regime fairly established in our country. But I believe if the CSR regime, and especially the corporate volunteering at the core of it, and this has to become a mainstream of corporate social responsibility. We cannot be just one another stream. We have to be the mainstream. And therefore, we need to understand what all it takes to be a successful volunteer and to be leading a successful voluntary movement.